Throw it on your toes.
Okay, ready, one. Don't you dare, because if it breaks, it's probably 50 cents. Mindy.
Hello and good morning, everyone. Welcome back. Thank you for being here for our family. We're so grateful that you decided to tune in today. It's gonna be an awesome day. I'm holding the camera further away so you cannot see all the spots on my face. I went and had a chemical peel done today on my face. Kind of turned it like a little bit like orangey yellow because of the stuff that they used on my face. And not only that, I can't wear any makeup today. So quite a few blemishes. That's why I'm holding the camera just a little bit further away so you guys don't have to stare at this face. Today is Thursday. Weekend starts now for us because it is an online Friday tomorrow. Kids are just getting home. Rexon, we were a little unsuccessful at the book fair this time. Rexon could not find a book that he wanted. He said, I'll look tomorrow at recess. So today, during school, at recess, he was able to look and see what kind of book he wanted. And, well, he found one. It is a Marvel book. It's Miles Morales Shockwaves. Mm-hmm. And he loves it. We all came into the house. I couldn't figure out why, like, the door down there was open and it felt warm in here. I walked out there. It's because Brexy was sitting in the car reading his book.
I just read a page after school and I just couldn't stop reading it.
It's a good one, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Brexy says, I just can't put this book down. So I'm gonna let him read as long as he will read. He has a book report coming up next month. But the kids are getting busy doing their after school duties. I told them, you guys, we really need your help today. Let's make it so we can have a super fun weekend. Just get all the jobs done today. So Ryler is changing really quick so he can mow the lawn. He's actually heading off with his friends today to go to the BYU game. That will be really fun for him. Kirby's gonna help me do his chores. As soon as Brexon's done reading, he will help me. Miss Hazy is also gonna help me out a little bit. Lots going on this afternoon, but you guys, I'm so excited to be starting the weekend right now. These online Fridays are pretty fun. They're pretty exciting. Kids just need to get their work done. Hopefully tomorrow isn't too painful. Working on the homework, unless they can finish it tonight. Alright, Ryler was mowing the lawn. He had to come inside for a temporary rain out.
Yep.
So now he's heading back out.
Almost done.
Ryler was edging. I went outside to get video of him edging. Hazel has been here. It's a full thing of ice cream in the afternoon. Wow. She was just reading and all of a sudden now she's transformed into this little ice cream eating munchkin. I went outside to get video of Ryler edging and he disappeared. It was dumping rain for about 3 minutes. Now he's back out there. He's gonna mow. He knows the ticket to going to that game tonight to get this lawn done.
Get a book that you like, it's so easy.
Right, guy, earning it today. Mow the lawn.
He's getting the reward. Going to the game.
Bro, go Utes. Am I right?
Yeah.
Okay.
See ya.
They're not even in this game, but Utah State is playing
against
BYU. Should be fun. You have the most insane weekend coming up, man. Like every day he has something
epic.
Don't
tell the people what's happening tomorrow.
Okay, the people will not know.
All right, bye.
Love you. Bye. Speaking of tomorrow and some of the epic plans we have that we're not yet divulging to the people, apparently. Mom, in advance, ordered up some really fun activities for Hazy because here's a little teaser. Hazy will not be involved. Neither will Brexon. Crew and Ryder will.
But I'll miss you.
Let me tell you, Hazy could not be more thrilled. Has never been more excited in her life for us to be leaving. Let's say she's got some fun plans up her sleeve with probably her favorite person on planet Earth. And so that is going down. Mom got her some fun activities so that they can be very busy and very entertained while we are gone doing our thing.
I think it will be so much
fun. It's gonna be awesome. As we do every day, daily trip to the house, and every day something new going down, something exciting happening. The hardy has been painted. The color that we chose and love matches so perfectly to the stucco, the stone. It's a cloudy day, so it really does not emphasize accent or highlight like the
it
color. On the sunny days, it gets really bright white. It's kind of cool how it like morphs with the weather and the mood. So the hardy is all of these sections here, here, the slats going this way, up there. It's all been painted, and they've added the columns to the front here as you enter the home. And then the most exciting thing, I think, really is starting to show what the backyard's gonna look like is they did the walls, or at least cinder block version of the walls that go to the pool.
Yeah.
So let's go back and check those out.
Let's do it.
Haven't been in the pool for a while, and it's not really necessarily swimming weather, but we did come out. We wanted to show you some of the things that they've done here in the pool. You've got the walls going up over there. Those are gonna be those jumping platform walls. It is, again, just like the wall in front. Cinder block to start gives you that nice foundation, and then they will take the stone from the home, put it on the outside of this, so it's gonna be that same stone laid on here all the way down. Does it go all the way down, sweetie? Is it gonna be our stone on this lower section too? All the way down, and that's gonna be like where you put the loungers, where you kind of just hang out, lay out, things like that. And then you've got the 4-foot jumping and the 6-foot jumping. We'll say this, they told us that this wall here at the end slide's gonna be coming off of
of this, but it's not gonna be that high. Not gonna have that much of a jump if you come off into the water. They just say that it's easier to lay these walls out as they are, one piece, and once we figure out exactly where we want the slide to go, they will carve out a section down in there. As it comes down, it'll kind of come down through that into an opening, and then you'll jump out into the deep end. So very cool. Mom's going up there. You can get an idea of how tall those 6 foot jumping ledges are up there. Kids are going to absolutely love that. The other thing that they've got going on in here is the tile, you guys. Check out how gorgeous this tile is. It's funny because I don't think I've ever looked at or paid attention to tile around the edge of a pool. And then when we went to choose the tile, I was like, who cares? Like, it only shows like half above water, half below water. But basically everything in the showroom
was more or less included in the bid. So you could get any one that you wanted. There's not really any major difference in pricing. But I think the one we went with, that gray tile, it's gonna go all the way around this entire edge of the pool. And that's going to be stunning. And then we have a white plaster bottom to make that water pop super nice bright blue, going for that Turks and Caicos blue. And then these things are prepping. They do these visual tile lines here so that you can see where the edges of steps are. It also just looks really nice. And we're working on the TIHWB tile to go across here in the Baja or Shamu deck. But lots of progress here on the pool. I'm gonna come up here on this side. Then we're gonna be coming back tomorrow to finish up that tiling. It's really cool to see these walls that we're gonna be jumping off of into the water. And then picture coming down that slide as they build the hill up there.
So that's all the walls for the pool and the front. Foundationally, they're done.
Yeah, except I think we're gonna extend them a little more this way, you said,
should
right?
we? I kinda want to. I'm gonna ask him if
I
that's possible.
I think we need to.
Mindy made a brilliant observation that half of that wall is
over the pool cover, so if you jump,
you can't jump there.
And it might need to take a visit to the emergency room.
Yeah, so if half of that ledge is pool cover, it's not a lot of jumpable space, and since I know that's where 90% of the jumping will take place, I'd rather build that a little longer this way. Build this one out a little longer.
At least, 18 inches, 2 feet.
And I think we could shorten this. This is pretty long layout deck here. We're not really the laying out type, more of the jumping off of cliffs type. Speaking for everyone but you.
I am. No, I think this is perfect.
This is what we're talking about. Mindy notices from across there. Basically, all of this is all jumping ledge wall here. None of it is anywhere you'd want anybody to jump from. I don't want anybody jumping from here, from here, from here. And even as you come across this way, I still don't want anybody this close to the ledge. And so usable jumping space maybe starts here. So that section, I don't know, pretty long, but it would be the shortest one. I think by far this would be the most jumped off of part. I do think, I just text our builder, and they're gonna tell the guys to add 2 more of these blocks worth to that inside part there, and another 2 feet there. I don't know, before I pull that trigger, let's go actually do some measurements.
Rather than measuring, just gonna get our hands dirty. I'm gonna go to work here. I'm gonna pour this pool. Might as well build the wall too. But am I gonna be able to balance on this thing and not fall?
You'll be good. You'll be good. But we were just like, I don't know, should we do this? Should we do that? And I says, why don't we just use our brain? Go grab a couple of them, throw them down, and let's see what we think. Just so you know, heads up, there's some right behind the wall that would be closer to grab for next time.
But you wouldn't have got all this great footage. How do they do this? I'm barely balanced.
They're probably not wearing flip flops.
True.
There you go, honey. Look at you.
What do you think? 2? Kind of hard to tell unless you go higher. Are they gonna do the stone on the back side of the wall too?
Probably not.
You don't have to put all these back when I'm done.
Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. Big guns. Careful, remember you have stitches in your back.
Oh yeah.
No B, sorry.
I know, sweetie. I can't get up that high with my shoulder that's not attached to my collarbone.
Oh, gross. I just vomited in my mouth. Don't drop it in the bottom. That'd be bad.
Mindy just showed you. We added the blocks here. I think it absolutely needs to go that far. You've got more space to jump with. You started adding blocks to this side. Mindy's videoing me, videoing her. Hi. Instagram, this is Zoe Bingham. Check it out over there. Anyways, when we added some blocks to this side, because the idea was just extend everything, because we don't need that long for loungers. But as we did that, glad we physically did it, because we realized you'd be jumping off of that into shallow. And
yeah,
and so
I think if you were to jump right here, it's too shallow.
So I think that we don't add to the 4 foot. We add to the 6 foot, make that longer. 4 foot's a great size, just a fun little middle ground, because people aren't gonna jump there if they have the chance to jump there. So that's just cool, but not necessary. And then leave that nice and long for lounging. So I think we're good. So you can put it all back now. I'll see ya.
I was just gonna say, I don't have to move these, right?
I'm gonna
Maybe
put them back.
Yeah. Put it on your toes.
Okay, ready, 1. Don't you dare, because if it breaks, it's probably 50 cents. Mindy, very easily broken.
I bought it.
Yeah, you break it, you buy it. This is a perfect shot of what it's been looking like, why it's been bugging me, and then what it will look like. So they're painting that right now. Look how beautiful that white color is. And then all of this will be that same color as well, coming together.
Also, I am so glad that Mindy caught that and saw that when we changed it. So we will be adding 2 blocks. I took them back down, but adding 2 blocks to that section, nothing to the 4 foot section, and leaving the 2 foot section as is. I think that's going to be the perfect mixture for that jumping wall.
Right.
Bry Guy not quite home from the game just yet. A few minutes left in the final quarter. Hopefully he's having fun cheering for a losing team.
Well, technically they're winning.
I know. They win a lot. And Maddie goes there, so I am a supporter in general. But anyways, we got to get the other kids in the bed though, because we do have pretty epic and potentially very late night coming up tomorrow night. We've teased it quite a bit, but we promise it's going to live up to the hype.
It's
Maddie's
gonna be awesome.
Birthday tomorrow. Doing something super epic. Kind of just lines up, but it also is kind of a perfect way to honor her. Something that she loves. I'm just going to keep going with the teasing here. She can't be here, but something that she did very similarly with us last year, just before she left. Now can you put it together? Probably not. Come back tomorrow. Very, very fun.
Wish Maddie happy birthday, because tomorrow is, like Brandon said, her birthday. She is the big 2-0. She is now into her 20s.
What? I have a 20-year-old?
I know.
How old does that make me? How could a 31-year-old have a 20-year-old? That is insane.
How could a 29-year-old have a 20-year-old? Thanks for being here with us today. We love you so much. Come back tomorrow. Maybe at that point, my face will be peeling off.
Ah.
Love you guys. We'll see you all tomorrow.
Good night, everybody. Get our hands dirty. I'm gonna go to work here. I'm gonna support this pool. Might as well build the wall too. You don't have to put all these back when I'm done.
Put on your toes.
Okay, ready? One. Don't you dare, because if it breaks, it's probably 50 cents.
Mindy,
you break it, you buy it.